And in this moment, I swear, we are infinite. Draw myself like Theta Kylo, see the
beauty in my sorrow. I want me to smile on my face. Things I think while making big batches
Smudge.
Of slime.
I just poured 40 pounds of glue in this mixer. My arms are killing me.
Let's make this look pretty. Oh wait, this looks like blood, doesn't it? He on trend for Halloween nice. Well, this is gonna make like 300 slime.
I remember when the trend was to try and make slime without glue, or no glue slimes. There were so many tutorials on YouTube talking about how you could make slime with things like hair gel or salt or just plain water. I'm honestly not sure if they lied or not because mine never turned out. They were just kind of gelatinous and gross. But if you guys ever made no glue slimes and they worked, please tell me how you did it. Why is the slime $13 if the ingredients cost a lot less? Which is a great question, but it's actually how all businesses work. It's kind of like a restaurant. The supplies might cost $3, but you're paying $20 for the convenience and a professional chef. If you want to gather your own supplies and make your own slime, that's completely fine, but other people would prefer to leave it to the professionals and get it ready-made. Hopefully that helps.
I didn't know what to do with these chips, so I put them in my slime. Crunchy chip slime. Adding in these cube charms for the aesthetic. Mix. Chips were coming out of the bowl, how rude. It actually smells like chips, OMG. So cronk. WTF have I just...
We get this question all the time. Our best sellers change week to week, but our food-based slimes and then our DIY clay kits tend to sell out the quickest. Right now though, our sugar cookie ice cream sandwich kits have been selling like crazy. I make so much of this. Lemon ice cream is definitely one of my favorites, so let's make another batch together. I started with 4 gallons of glue, and then we're gonna add the color and the scent. And of course, a ton of clay to make it smooth and creamy. After we mix it, I'll add some snow just to make sure it's the right consistency, and then you have lemon ice cream.
Let's make egg pudding together. First, we add our eggs and oil to the mixer. Egg. Then we mix it all together. This one smells like sweet boardwalk taffy and comes with this cute little egg to mix in.
Mixing pigment into slime is one of the most satisfying things to me. And I just got this new one, so let's test it out and some clear slime together. In the end, it turned out so pretty and shiny, so help me name in the comments.
Making a fresh batch of honey butter.
Let's make a batch of Cookie Monster's cookie dough together. First, we added all of the cookies, and then we added chocolate chunks. Then we had to finish it off with some blue dye to make sure Cookie Monster's cookie dough looked like him. Once everything is mixed together, this is what it looks like. The scent is chocolate chip cookie dough with hints of chocolate and marshmallow. It's really yummy. And that's how you make Cookie Monster's cookie dough. Let's make a slime together. We're making a really big batch of one of our best sellers right now, Lavender Latte. This one uses a metallic pigment and a purple pigment. Mixing this one up can be so satisfying, but also super messy and the glitter gets everywhere. And that's how you make Lavender Latte. Let's make another slime together. This one is Sailor Moon Frost, and I already have the base put together, so we're just adding in the colors and the pigment. It has the yummiest watermelon bubblegum scent, which is what we're adding in right now. We let that mix until it's completely incorporated, we add all of the extra sprinkles and pigment, and it's ready to go. Since the slime is a pink and purple swirl, I use both mixers to make it. The finished product has the nicest sizzly texture and a really pretty purple color. I wanna go.
Let's make honey butter together.
Smooth like butter, like a criminal undercover.
Let's make blueberry muffins together. We already have our batter made, so we're gonna add blueberries, eggs, and then some oil to that. Mix it all together and it should look like this. Then we're gonna spoon our batter into our mini muffin tins and bake. And that's how you make blueberry muffins. This is definitely one of my new favorite products in the shop. It smells exactly like blueberry muffins. This is definitely one of my favorite parts of making slime too. The clay blocks are always fun to add in and they're really fun to squish. And since we use over 300 of them in the shop per week, we definitely have a lot of videos of them. Which one was your favorite? Let's make some Nutella ice cream. This one's really easy. We already have our milk, cream, and sugar in our bowl, and we're gonna add some Nutella. I top mine off with some chocolate truffles and cream cheese. We're gonna mix this one together for 25 minutes, and then you have Nutella ice cream. This one smells exactly like Nutella. It's so good. Today we're going to be making honey butter. First, I drizzled some fresh honey onto this cream cheese and we're going to add that to the mix. Then, of course, we have our honey infused oil we're adding. Once that is incorporated, we're going to add some fresh honey drizzle on top. It smells exactly like honey and fresh buttered bread. And then the texture is super inflating and sizzly. It's so good.
Things I think while filming videos. Can't wait to eat this. Those eggs look sus. Still gonna eat it though. Pour. Mix.
Why did I film this outside?
No, seriously. There is no oven out here.
How TF did these get baked?
In getting ripped tonight.
R.I.P.
That cookie.
Let's make some sugar cookies together. So I already have most of our ingredients pre-measured in the bowl. We're gonna add some sprinkles, our eggs, and of course the milk. And of course, we have to add some cookies back into the mixer for crunch. Then we're gonna mix everything together and it should look like this. And then you have sugar cookie dough. I turned mine into these cute little ice cream sandwiches I'm selling in my shop right now. Let's make cookies and cream fudge together. All of our ingredients are in the bowl and we're gonna add some Oreos and some cream cheese. Mix that all together until it's completely incorporated and it should look like this. The texture on this one is so soft and smooth. Plus, we hand blended the scent to smell exactly like cookies and cream with notes of chocolate and crumbled cookies. Comment below if you would try this. Let's make some homemade cookie dough together. I've already added all of our dry ingredients into the bowl, and then we're gonna add some milk. Then the secret ingredient, we're gonna add some cookies back into the cookie dough for crunch. Mix that together for about 25 minutes, and there you have cookie dough. This is one of my favorite new scents in the shop. It smells amazing, just like cookies, and it's available right now. Let's make a margarita. First, we add our ice cubes and limes to our simple syrup and add that to the margarita mix. Mix everything together until it turns into this pretty green color, and then we're gonna add some shimmery pigment. This one smells so yummy and refreshing, just like limes and salt. And that's how you make a margarita. Here's how to make my favorite chocolate chip cookies. To make the cookie dough, you'll add brown sugar, white sugar, flour, of course, some butter, and two eggs. Then add all of the chocolate chips and some vanilla extract. Then we mix it all together, and eventually it turns into cookie dough. Then we're gonna bake them for 0 degrees for no time at all, and then you have cookies. And then you can add some ice cream and their little cookie sandwiches. Let me know if you try my recipe at home. Today we're making a lavender latte. First we add our ice cubes to simple syrup and steep our lavender leaves. Once that's steeped, we're gonna add it to our heavy cream and mix. I had to have everyone in the shop help me make this scent because I've never personally had a lavender latte, but it smells so good with hints of lavender, vanilla, and coffee. Let's make taro boba slush together. So I already made the icy base and then we scented it like taro. Next we had to color it that really pretty purple color and add the taro boba sprinkle mix. And it's ready to go.
Hi. I know your bed is comfy, but you got to get up. Cause this world needs an awesome person like you.
Hey guys, let's make another slime together. Today we're making 6 gallons of Nature's cereal. You guys have quickly made this one a bestseller, so I make so much Nature's cereal each week. And I totally get why. It smells like fresh fruit and it has cute little berry charms. Have you tried Nature's cereal yet? It is your best-selling slime. So this week, the two that you guys really, really loved are pumpkin spice latte slime and then our strawberry cow. But it definitely varies week by week. Like the one that I'm making right now is pink lemonade. And it's a best-selling favorite that I decided to bring back. Do you guys have any more questions? Ask me in the comments. Why does one slime cost $13? The short answer would be quality. You can definitely find some cheaper factory-made slimes at places like Amazon or Target, but there's gonna be a big difference in the quality. It's the same reason you won't find our slime in those same places. Handmade professional slimes have to be cared for, whereas mass-produced slimes use different chemicals so it can last for years on the shelf. No shade to people who like store-bought slimes, they're just two completely different products at two different price points. And just because you find a $5 slime in Target doesn't mean that our prices aren't reasonable. What is your favorite type of slime to make? It would definitely have to be an icy slime. The texture is so fluffy and soft, and it looks just like snow. Which is actually pretty funny because my biggest pet peeve is the sound of crunching snow. It makes me physically cringe and just makes me feel so uncomfortable every single time I hear it. Thankfully, icy slime is sizzly and soft like snow, but it doesn't have those gross wet crunches. Okay, you guys, you know what time of year it is. I wanted to show you guys some of my favorite Christmas cookies. I know frosted sugar cookies can kind of be controversial. Some people love them, some people hate them, but these ones are delicious. I wanted this slime to look just like real milk and cookies, so of course the base looks like milk and scented like sugar cookies. When the clay and the slime are mixed up, it turns into a really soft clay slime that's great for bubble pops.
How many slimes do I make per day? Honestly, it's a lot. On average, I'd say we make about 1,000 slimes a day. But with our Black Friday sale going on and a lot of people wanting to order for the holidays, we've really been trying to step it up. We've been preparing for this for an entire month, and lately we've been making over 2,000 slimes a day. But this definitely depends on the week and what kind of slime I'm making. Some take a lot more time than others. And that's why it's not always easy to answer. So, a lot of people seem to get upset at the fact that I called ourselves professional slime makers. And I hear you, it sounds kind of funny. But considering the business sells one product that we sell thousands of each week and we spent years perfecting the recipes for, I'm not really sure what else to call it. Beyond just the ingredients in a slime, we've also picked up so many tips and tricks on how to make it the best slime possible. Anyways, what do you guys think we should be called? I found a rat in the slime that I made. You know, this happens to us all the time here at Peachy Babies. We just keep finding rats in our slime. It's gotten so bad that we've actually just been keeping them as pets. But sometimes we just need to add a little extra flavor to the slime. It's so crazy that this girl figured out our secret recipe so quickly.